Many of us have been staying at home for the last few weeks, in isolation with our families or with our flatmates. A group of scientists is now starting an expedition, where they will also be isolated, but in a different setting, on a ship in the middle of the North Atlantic Ocean.
Hi, my name is Laura.
My name is Arne.
My name is Mick Smith.
My name is Clara.
I'm David Stalling.
They are an international team of researchers from all over the world, working together in Ireland in the Dublin Institute for Advanced Studies.
My name is Raffaele.
My name is Daniel.
Hi, my name is Jolika.
I'm Sergei Lebedev.
In 2018, they deployed 18 seismometers at the bottom of the North Atlantic Ocean, thousands of meters deep down in the dark water, below the level of the sea, to discover the secrets of the Earth's interior below the oceans. Can we know more about the movement of the tectonic plates? How are the earthquakes made? Where are the volcanoes from?
The sea, while we're out at sea, and SEA stands for seismics. So that's what we measure. We use seismic waves to discover the structure of the Earth.
I'm using the vibrations generated by the ocean and the atmosphere with the ground to study the structure onshore island.
I'm a PhD student and I'm working on extinct volcanoes in the North Atlantic.
Our Sea-Seis team here includes people from different walks of life, and it's been a lot of fun working with them.
Now it's time to recover these instruments and the unique data they have recorded from the bottom of the ocean. But life on a research vessel has its challenges. Corridors are narrow. Cabins are tiny. Stairs are steep. The weather is often terrible. Having lunch in the kitchen is like eating a soup on a roller coaster. And if you happen to be in a storm, then it is when you're asked to become a hero. Once the storm is gone, the exciting challenges are back. The adventure, the joy of the discovery, the friendship, the spirit of exploration, and the ocean, turbulent and great.
Not the first days, it had been quite a rough weather, but now it's brilliant. It's a nice team and lots of success, so it's really good.
It's complicated, but yeah, I have bruises all around my body.
It's been great, great team. Great camaraderie, all that sort of stuff, but it's been excellent.
The data are unique, and they will give us new insight into the deep structure of the Irish offshore, and also in the life of the great baleen whales of the North Atlantic.
Getting out deep into the Atlantic on a boat, I think it's a once-in-a-lifetime experience. That's one that I feel very privileged to be able to have.
I'm on a boat, just walking around, trying to get from one room to the other without falling over. As you can see, it's moving. I'm holding on.
It takes a while to get used to the constant motion.
I love being here. It's very interesting.
Why am I here? Who doesn't want to be here? We are on a research vessel going toward Iceland and the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. It's a great experience and a terrific adventure.
The Sea-Seis team is back on board the Celtic Explorer in April 2020 for the retrieval of the 18 seismometers left at the bottom of the North Atlantic Ocean in 2018.